and Top 40.
We have 'em, radio's 40 top hits of the week. I'm Casey Kasem. Well, now we're up to the song No Such Thing by John Mayer, a super hot newcomer who never goes anywhere without a very special pillowcase. It's a bit like the superstitions that many athletes have. Baseball players, for instance, are famous for having lucky socks or lucky gloves that they take with them everywhere. A little bit of superstition that may or may not guarantee them a good game. In the case of singer and songwriter John Mayer, what he's got to help him along is a pillowcase. Of course, it's not just any pillowcase. He says it's a Star Wars, The Empire Strikes Back pillowcase, which he's had for years. In fact, he's been carrying it around for so long that there's not much left of it. John says, quote, "It's been washed so many times, it has no fiber left in it. But it's always with him because, well, you never know." This week, his first hit song moves up two notches to number 37 on American Top 40. Here's John Mayer with No Such Thing.
Counting down the hits with Casey Kasem.
Falling four notches is a singer and songwriter who got his start playing coffee houses in Atlanta, Georgia. Here's John Mayer at number 20 with No Such Thing. These are radio's hottest hits by music's hottest stars. Hot star John Mayer says that unlike some of his fellow performers, he's a nice guy. John says, quote, "I like being a nice guy. I think a lot of artists are purposely not nice because they feel like it really augments their image. I like making records and being good at making records and playing the guitar and singing. And when I'm off the job, I'm like, hi, how are you?" Unquote. Here's nice guy John Mayer, up two notches to number 28 with Your Body is a Wonderland. We're counting down the 40 biggest hits in the 50 states, and moving back up two notches is an artist born in the state of Connecticut, home of the world's first telephone book. Now, looking in the AT40 yellow pages under singer and songwriter, here's John Mayer at number 16 with Your Body is a Wonderland.
Casey comes out down.
This is Casey coming to you from Hollywood. John Mayer's new album may be titled Heavier Things, but the record has a decidedly light tone to it. John says, quote, "The only real criterion for the record was, is it fun to play? Is it physically fun to feel the vibration of the strings or the feel of my throat when I'm singing? If an idea didn't meet that criterion, it was dumped." Unquote. Singing a song that fit the bill, here's John Mayer falling one notch to number 25 with Bigger Than My Body.
Counting down the hits with Casey Kasem.
Now, here's a musician who grew up in Fairfield, Connecticut. John Mayer moves from number 17 to 16 with Clarity.
Our words.
Casey's Coast to Coast.
Well, now we're up to an American Top 20 Extra by John Mayer, a star who says there's only one band he's ever wanted to be a member of, and they're not looking for a new singer. John says the band that he admires the most is Coldplay. Quote, "I've always been happy to work on my own, but I listen to Coldplay and I hear an inner strength that I envy." He says one of the things that he likes most about Coldplay is that, quote, "They don't come across as kings of the world. They're a really great underdog. The band has to try harder. And you can hear that struggle on their last record, X and Y. I'd offer them my services, but I think someone else has the singer job all locked up." Now, with an extra, here's John Mayer, the solo artist, with a smash from last year, Daughters.
Number 3.
Up a notch is John Mayer, a singer who made an appearance just a few days ago on the season's first episode of CSI. He was a musician performing in a bar, and the song he performed was Waiting on the World to Change. We're dashing up the chart, and we're up to a singer who's always ready for a dash, thanks to his large collection of Nike and New Balance. Those are John Mayer's favorite brands of athletic shoes. He estimates he's got at least 200 pairs, and when he goes on tour, he takes at least two dozen with him. Quote, you want to be ready for anything. Here's John Mayer, back up a notch to number four with Waiting on the World to Change.
Number 14.
Up two notches is John Mayer, a musician who says he's happy to try writing songs about anything, except what he calls fame and the trappings of fame. John says, quote, that's just too me, me, me. Now, here's John getting far away from himself, singing about gravity.
Coast to coast.
I'm Casey Kasem. It was back on April 16th that a student at Virginia Tech, a lone gunman, shot and killed 32 people who had shown up that day to teach and to learn. It was one of the darkest days in American history, and it left the students at Virginia Tech in shock and in mourning. A new school year is about to begin at Virginia Tech, and to show their support and concern for the students, a number of major musicians have offered to give a free concert in the school stadium. At the top of the list are John Mayer and the Dave Matthews Band, and it's a member of the Dave Matthews Band who explained why they wanted to do it. Drummer Carter Buford told the student paper, quote, we have a profound respect for the incredible resolve and unwavering sense of hope the university community has shown. We are honored to have the opportunity to share an evening with Virginia Tech. Now, with an extra, here's John Mayer from 2003, Bigger Than My Body. This week back in 2004, one of the top hits in the USA was Daughters. It's by a man who realized early on he was never going to be a great guitar player. But he decided he could still be a star. When John Mayer was 13 years old, a neighbor gave him a tape of blues guitar legend Stevie Ray Vaughan. And John Mayer decided he wanted to be a great blues guitar player too. By the time he was 15, John was good enough to play blues at local clubs, but he realized he wasn't that good. He says, all I was doing was copying somebody. I wasn't good enough to make the blues my own. On the other hand, his songwriting was totally original. So John Mayer enrolled at the Berklee College of Music in Boston to study songwriting, and he found himself as a musician. Quote, more than anything, I love to stand in front of a mic and let the songs just flow out of me. This week back in 2004, John Mayer had one of the top hits in the USA. Here's Daughters. This week back in 2002, one of the top hits in the USA was Your Body is a Wonderland. It's by a star who has only one non-negotiable backstage request, a nice bowl of breakfast cereal. John Mayer says he's found that he really needs a good-sized supply of breakfast cereals to get himself ready for a show. John says, quote, cereals with a good marshmallow to oats ratio, like Lucky Charms. It's exquisite. You eat the oats and are left with marshmallow nirvana. I always have cereal before I go on. It puts me in just the right mood. And this week back in 2002, John Mayer gave us a big spoonful of music, one of the top hits in the USA with Your Body is a Wonderland.
Number 17.
Up a notch, here's John Mayer, a musician who's assembled a collection of nearly two dozen touring musicians so he can change his band from show to show. John says, quote, just to keep things interesting. Here's John with Say.
Casey counts them down.
Hit by hit, we're heading toward the top of the chart. Holding at number six is John Mayer, a singer who recently grew philosophical during an interview. He told the reporter, quote, when I hear somebody say life is hard, I always want to ask, compared to what? Here's John. Here's John with Say.
Casey counts them down.